ఐపెన్ కదా లైక్ ఫైన్ ఓకే సో హియర్ వీ హార్ ఫైన్ ఫైన్ హియర్ వీ ఆర్ కంటిన్యూ అండ్ అడ్మిట్ ఆల్ ఫైన్ సో అడ్మిట్ ఆల్ సో హియర్ వీ హ్యావ్ మల్టిపుల్ ఓపెన్ ఫోల్డర్స్ And is my screen getting shared? Is it clear? The screen is clear?
Yes, sir.
Oh, that's fine. That's fine. I think people are still getting admitted. Fine. So we are discussing determined abroad knowledge. Why it is important, why it should be done. So previous class you're getting it right, you're getting an idea right? People who are very new, everything new ga unnaro risk assessment gunchi oka idea vastundi kada. నేను ఎగ్జాంపుల్ చూపిస్తాను లైక్ ఐ విల్ బి షోయింగ్ ద రియల్ టైమ్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్ సో యూ కెన్ హ్యావ్ ఎ క్లియర్ లుక్ అట్ ఇట్ ఓకే సో ఇవన్నీ మనకి జస్ట్ వెయిట్ ఓకే ఇట్ ఆల్ అండ్ these are the different steps that have carried out. We have to carry out these kind of steps. We have already seen it. These are five basic steps. Not only do while doing the risk assessment, see, remember the risk assessment chesetappude kaakunda meeri steps anevi daily mee routine lo aap jo rounds mein jayega na us samay aur koi kaam kar rahe aur koi workers aapka under niche kaam kar rahe उसका रिस्क कैलकुलेट करने के भी ये स्टेप्स हम लोग फॉलो करेगा ठीक है और सेकंड थिंग ఏంటంటే ఇవేదైతే ఉన్నాయో డైలీ రొటీన్ లో మనం ఏదైతే రౌండ్స్ కి వెళ్తామో ఇవన్నీ ఒక్కసారి ఫాస్ట్ గా క్యాల్కులేట్ చేసుకోవాలన్నమాట ఓకే క్యాల్కులేట్ చేసుకుంటేనే యూల్ బి యువర్ ప్రొజెక్షన్స్ విల్ బి యూల్ బి ఎ గుడ్ సేఫ్టీ ఆఫీసర్ ఓకే సి ఫైన్ ఓన్లీ దెన్ ఓన్లీ ఇఫ్ యూ కెన్ టాక్ only if you can identify, you can, only if you can evaluate, okay, only then you will be the best of people, okay. For that you have to work on, you have to keep working, fine. Okay, so hazards ela identify cheyalani cheptunaru, like how we'll identify the hazards. So hazards are identified, hazards already exist in many places. They are identified by experience, also by having a good knowledge on the particular work and also the environmental conditions. Okay, there may be new hazards which you can find only when you go onto the workplace. Okay, so you have to look all the aspects of work. What are the aspects of work? Usually see how before going to the finding out hazards, I just want to quote a very important point regarding this risk assessment. See, each and every work can be subdivided into different parts. Okay, fine. If you are seeing a hot work, first it can be divided into different parts. If a pipe is getting welded, okay, the pipe is overhead. Okay, and if a pipe is getting welded or maintenance of a pipe is going to happen, the main purpose of the work is a worker has to go above 6 feet from the ground level. He has to cut the pipe and re-weld it. That is the activity. So what is involved here? Work at height is involved, hot work is involved, yes or no? Work at height, hot work, PPE is involved. Okay, so the work is divided into different parts. So each and every part, you'll take as a activity. So every activity has a hazard. Okay, you visualize, imagine chesukondi. Or for example, bike nadupnam. Oh, okay, we'll stick to this. So worker em chestaru, first worker height avutundi akada. Okay, hot work avutundi. So hot work ki hazards unde, worker height ki hazards unde. Actions and aggress anedi one of the activity we can take if the axis and aggress is very long enough. Okay, so different kinds, the work is divided and the work is subdivided in different parts, right? So each and every part has a hazard. Each and every part, if a hazard came into picture, each and every hazard has a consequence. Okay, depending upon the severity, you will project. If it is less severe, if the risk is less, for example, he is using a hammer. Okay, the hammer is in his pocket with a properly tool holding pocket. So, but he is not having a proper hand grip. Okay, but the hammer is having a rope which is attached to his hand, but it is not having hand grip. That hazard, you can take it as a you cannot take that hazard into priority one. Even if it slips, it will hang to his hand, but there is a probability of slipping, right? So in that way you will calculate. If he is not wearing earplugs, you will also take it as a medium level hazard. Okay, fine. So this is how the hazards are identified. Non-routine activities also should be included. Non-routine activities are activities which are not done on daily basis. Okay, maintenance, cleaning. Okay, look at accident, incident, and near miss. Usually, how the accident happened? How it happens? If something has failed, how it happens? There is a hierarchy. There is a hierarchy in such a way that first thing there is a and if. Unsafe condition can lead to unsafe action lead to unsafe condition, right? Unsafe actions lead to unsafe conditions. Unsafe conditions lead to near miss. Okay, note it down. Already I told, I don't know how many people heard about this previously. And near miss leads to incident. Incident leads to accident. Okay, this is how an accident can happen. This is the hierarchy of something can go wrong. Fine. So where we are? No. Okay. So induce people of work site other than home, job site, drivers. So we have to include all the peoples like trainers. We have to job people who are working on site, drivers, teleworkers, clients, everyone. We have to include when we are taking. If we are making a on site analysis or on site risk assessment, we have to include an activity called training activity. Okay, if some trainer is coming and he is taking a training on mission, okay, so he should be accompanied with buddy. That is the risk. If he is not accompanied with buddy, what will be the risk? Risk will be high. Initially, you'll give high risk. That's an administrative control. Okay, in that way, look the foreseeable and unusual condition. What do you mean by foreseeable? Means you have to look beyond the actual situations. Okay, what can be the foreseeable? Means you are looking into something which may happen, okay, which can cause harm. Okay, so here we have determined what are the product, mission, equipment, and initially unintentionally changed. So you also see in what way the mission and equipment can be intentionally or unintentionally changed. It means that you have to see if there are any buttons accessible to the common people. Is there any emergency button which is accessible without any guards? Okay. Are there any trip hazards? Okay. Is the moving equipment guarded or not? In that way, you have to. If you are doing the risk assessment to the mission, even the mission can be subdivided into different parts. Feeding end, right? Feeding point at which the feeding happens. Okay. Otherwise, if it depending upon the activity what the machine does. Okay, if it is doing punching, okay, you will do the you will divide the machine into different activities like feeding and punching process. Okay, the process at which the men are involved, that the core activity of the machine. Okay, guys.
Sir, in this, sorry, sir, I'm interrupting. Is not no column for who might be harmed.
This one, don't take it. This is not the standard one. I'll be showing. This is not standard one. I just want to show people. Before going to the risk at all of environment, I'll just show one. Wait. This is a core concept. Okay. Ignore this hazard identification assessment, which is present. Okay, here. Okay. Can everyone have a look at it? Status of the event. See, previously we are discussing regarding the likelihood and severity. Okay. So in what way it is divided? Status of the event. You clearly understand this risk matrix. This is the core, and you can take a snapshot. You can work on it. You have to. You will base on this risk matrix when you are doing risk analysis as a part of risk assessment. Okay. So here, likelihood of event happening. That is what likelihood is. Okay. Likely outcome of the event. Outcome of the event you keep aside for a moment. You see likelihood of the event happening and the status of the event. Okay, so risk class, what where is the severity here? Severity is in the x-axis. Okay, major injury and fatal numerical. This is a combination of quantitative and qualitative analysis of risk analysis. Okay, you always take care of your word. Assessment is different, is analysis is different. Okay, analysis is you're calculating the likelihood into risk, likelihood into severity. That is analysis. Always remember. Fine. So likelihood of an event happening also given, they have given numbers. Like it is unlikely to happen. Understand very well. Unlikely means the probability of event occurring is very less. Ante your application. Fine. So probability of event, and you put, for example, I'll give you an example. We have taken,
so, sir, we check our previous data. Na? If your organization in 1 year, if any incident happened, we can consider it is likely or unlikely means it, throughout the company's work, we didn't find any incident regarding this particular hazard. So we can say, sir, unlikely.
See, sir, actually, likely and unlikely means, like, if you are not finding any incidents of particular hazards, it comes under unlikely. But yes, sir. But if that area at which the hazard is changed, or if some situations change in such a way that area is being used by many people, or there is a change in process, that can be again likely. You cannot just take granted that if some hazard is there. It's not only the hazard existing there, but people are involved. Not only people, the environmental conditions also you have to take into consideration, and the physical conditions also. If some hazard is existing, some hot work, if there's some kind of machine is getting heated up, okay, again there beside it which you have a gas plant where the hazard, you cannot take it as unlikely. It depends upon the situation or unsafe condition you are handling with. Okay, even if the machinery is somewhere in the corner where the people cannot go and touch it, okay, he may not get burned, but due to the increase in the surface temperature, due to the development of gases in the environment, it may auto ignite. That also you cannot take it unlikely. Okay, I just gave you an example, sir. Okay, please you can relate your thoughts related to that. Fine. But as for now, if an hazard, for now, for an example, what we are taking, like pedestrian path, there is a improper undulation, or there is a pit, uncovered hole. If it is existing somewhere else, where the people are walking very rarely, that comes under unlikely. The event, the probability of someone to fall in that hole is.
Sir, yes. 1 minute, sir. 1 minute. Sir. I have small doubt. Is there any guidelines for make that risk matrix, sir? Is there any guidelines?
Yes, sir. If you are coming based on the day standard, but the thing what I am showing you now is the exact guidelines on which you have to follow when you are taking the likelihood of when you are marking the likelihood number. When you are marking the severity number, you have to follow whether if something happens, if it is minor, if the hole is 100 feet deep. Okay, it's a fatality.
Okay.
If the hole is 2 feet deep, it can be a near miss or minor injury. Okay, in that way, sir. Fine, sir.
Okay,
this
sir.
Is
okay.
The guideline you have to follow throughout. So, if it is the risk is always our main motto is to the risk should fall under the green line. Means what is the maximum green line number? It's green. What is the maximum probability? 3 is L. And one, if it is three, right? This probability of combination, three, right? Yes. So we should make sure that it's under the acceptable limit. If it is under three, wherever you see, if it is likelihood is three and the severity is one. Yes, right? So it should fall. When coming to our example, if a person working beside water and person working beside sharp objects on a height without lifeline, okay, without lifeline, so probability of event to occur is four. Anything can occur. It's a four. You can say it will probably happen because without lifeline, otherwise without any edges. For example, if he is working beside water, you can give it as three, okay, because depending upon whether he has got the swimming skills or not, if whether he has provided the life buoy or not. If the life buoy is not there, if he doesn't know the swimming, the risk is four, okay. But if he is working sharp objects beside, the risk is five, very high. So four, five, 20, very high. VH is very high, H is high, L is low, M is medium. So this is how, see here he has determined the environment, what the environment aspect also, cost is determined, he's given in dollars, okay, fine, then severity. Usually in our factories and our act, we don't have this severity matrix, sir. This is taken from ISO standard and also NABOSH, OSHA's only, okay. Usually industries and factories or service industries are under ISO 45001. Previously there used to be OSHA's 18001. Now it is ISO 45001. So they follow these standards. Fine. So I hope everyone is clear with this matrix.
Yes, sir. Yes.
Fine. So I just want to quote two things. So here you have
one doubt, sir.
Please tell me.
About the environmental damages, sir, how we can assess it as a major or minor or how it is for okay for a person it is okay, minor injury, major injury.
Yes, yes. If it is environment, sir, see, environment, when we talk about environment, not only the natural calamities come into picture, but if we confine space is there, okay. The inside air may change, lack of oxygen deficiency, enrichment of oxygen, or lack the increase in the concentration of dust particles. Okay, if we take confined space into account, for example, our environment aspects, we will be our environment aspects. We'll take into consideration that how much a person can be affected, what is the particulate matter, how much accessibility we have, what are the control measures we have. Coming to the severity and likelihood, specifically speaking, we will give the severity in such a way that in what kind of environment he is working. If he is working in confined space and he is doing welding, the likelihood of a person to inhale the gases may be high or less depending upon the protective wear what he is using and the depth in which he is working. Okay. and the severity based on the severity based on the levels and the that one we take it into we'll take it as a confined space environment, sir. If he is working in a dusty environment where some chemicals are being processed, it depends upon the way he's working, where the threshold limit values again come into picture. So in that way, environmental issues will take into consideration when likelihood and severity will take in such a way that how much likely he is exposed to such an environment, and severity, how long, what is the type of chemical, what is the severity of the chemical, is it acid, confined space, how he is affected by that chemical or activity, we'll take it into consideration. Apart from these, there are environments which has an auto ignition conditions and also flash points. Some environments will take auto ignition conditions, flash points, and also different kinds of temperatures, humidity levels. It's inside the indoor premises. If it is coming to the outdoor environments, will consider regarding the if some natural calamity is going to come. So what are the preventive measures we have to take? Otherwise, how it going to affect our locality or premises? For example, we stack containers. If some warning has come from the IMD, Indian Meteorological Department, so what we do, we have this certain protocols to follow. No about single stacking, the crane should be anchored. So in this way, you'll find the likelihood and severity of the environment. Okay, sir. So depending upon this one, you will give the control measures when it comes to environment, only environment. Okay. Fine, sir. I don't know who asked the question. Sir, is it okay? So you're clear? Are you people can hear me?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Please continue.
Is my answer? Did you understand? I don't know who asked that, but this is how you.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Fine, sir. Fine. So if you are doing the risk assessment, you can add the environment column. And how, in what way you add the environment column? By making it as a, if it is you talking about dust, that comes under environment. You're talking about ventilation, that comes under environment. Indoor ventilations, illuminations, all comes under environment. Fine. So this is somewhat I just want to say. This is different kind. This is the standard what every risk assessment, depending upon the company standards, we have. Some companies have this, what I've shown, we have seen one colorful matrix, right? That's also been induced here. And I just want to show you. Fine. The reference number is marked. Okay. Fine. Okay. So you can see one risk assessment worksheet, right? You can see risk assessment worksheet.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
So yes, sir. Here, what is the main content here? Please understand. Here, activity we have mentioned: manual and mechanical material handling in warehouse, yards, and near the machinery. So it is saying that it's a manual and mechanical, means there's a material handling which is happening manually, people carrying bags, and also it happens by mechanical means, by forklifts or by hydras inside the warehouse, inside the standards. Okay, this is the standards we are following, and this is the risk assessment types matrix we are using. Fine. So it's a reference number which every what we say every company will have. No problem, I can show it due to for the audit purpose. Every company will have it. Okay, just a minute. Okay, see, it's VCT, CFS, RA, OPS, AM, manual and mechanical material handling. This is how you have to mention. If it is your company is some Ramco, okay, Ramco, RMC with the place, RMC anything. If it is sub, you can do it sub RA particular thing or RA of ops, and then MMHW means manual metal handling in warehouses. Okay, fine. So this is how you have to do it. Fine. So you have to, that is the audit purpose. For this, if you are doing this, for showing this to any audit purpose, you have to mention this reference number. If you, okay, and then the review number. Review number is 00. It is recently developed and I'm the part of it. Fine. Date of issue is recently, that is 16-3 last month.
Sir, how will you give the reference number, sir?
Reference number is given based on the ISO standard. Okay. For every reference number,
ISO
you
standard or our plan or
you can also follow that ISO standard. But if you to retrieve some file, you have to maintain one standard, like first the company name, what is the document type, okay, sir, and what that document saying RA, and then what does that RA means? That's a shortcut of that RA. In this way, this reference number is standard, sir. You, for you to retrieve something, you can use that reference number. Fine, sir. So review number is 00. Means if you are reviewing it, what is the review date? We have kept as 1 year. Okay. Meanwhile, if there is any change in the modifications, you'll do it and then keep a additional columns and the keep review number. So this is what we have done. We are 4 members team, QHSC manager ops, okay, this myself, and then SIC from the operation department who is working, who is taking under consideration, the works under consideration. So I would like you people to understand this very well. Okay, so see, what do you mean by task? How it is, it's a serial number or reference number. Okay, task. So you understand this entire thing, you can understand complete any risk assessment. Okay, this entire thing you have to understand. What is the here, what are the task? Manual material handling of materials like rice bags, 50 kg drums. Okay, rice bags is handling, 50 kg drums are being handling, animal feed bags are handling, green peas, gypsum boards. Okay, these are different kinds of activities of particular task. Okay, so different kinds of task based on the particular activity. Fine. This is how. So here, box of fertilizer packets, these are different activity. Okay, manual metal handling of rice bags activity. Okay, fine. So you can divide it to multiple number of columns, sorry, rows. Okay, and you can write each and everything in a differently. So here we have reefer container stuffing and destuffing. Okay, this is also a different task, which is different from this task. Fine. So coming to the hazards, what are the hazards when manual material handlings are happening? Excessive weights can be the hazards. Excessive weights, improper manual handling may be the hazard. Sliding of cargo, when the stacking of bags is being done, what can happen? The cargo can slide. These are the things which are given on site, which are given after discussion, which are given out of experience, okay, which are given by seeing the references of the workplace and hazards. They based on the experiences, based on the, okay, you can also look into the net base also, but in the real time what happens also you can keep it. Fine. So sliding of the cargo, that's a hazard. Falling cargo from height, hazard. Skin contact with fertilizers, hazards. Okay, skin contact with fertilizers. So coming in contact with passers while moving there, fine. So what is this actually mean is, when the people are stacking bags from one place to another into the containers or trolleys, these are the other facility what we have. Usually it happens in container freight stations. means places where container stuffing, de-stuffing, loading of cargo happens when the transit happens. Fine, where if some container comes from ship and you are the person who is owner of the container, who booked the container. So what I do, I give you the service. It comes from the ship, it comes into the yard, and it goes to the container freight station, where if your container can be opened up under the customs department, under the, and they, you can unload your material and take to your company. That's how this logistics business trade works.
So sorry to interrupt you. Actually, how to select risk priority criteria on which basis?
Based on the risk.
Risk severity criteria.
What do you mean? Risk severity maybe? Criteria. See, severity yes. criteria means you're quoting about severity criteria.
Yes.
Severity criteria is completely based on the work environment. I already told. See, if the severe, how you can differentiate severity? If severity is differentiated by minor injury, major injury, loss of time, how you will define? You define about depending upon the unsafe condition. You cannot just take a vague guess on the criteria instantly. To define the severity criteria, you will take some factors into consideration. Area of the work, place he is working. If something, if he has fallen or some likelihood has happened. So what is the effect? Depending upon the potential effect, you will give the severity criteria. Fine.
So for this, I hope we can give a good example. Like if you have a cable on the road, in the sense, the severity will be more. If the same cable is somewhere in the corner, the severity will be very less.
Yes.
That is totally depends upon the situation and scenario.
If severe, when it's coming to severity, a very good example, sir. I just want to talk to.
Just elaborate.
If a cable is power, if a cable is with power, live cable. Then severity comes into picture. If a cable is out road, on road, and off road is likelihood. If coming in, the persons coming in contact, vehicles coming in contact. Okay, if a cable is live cable, and if a cable is with joints, depends upon if then severity changes. If a cable is uninsulated,
the chance of slippery is there, and the chance of tripping hazard is there, the chance of electricity is there, and the man movement is there. In the corner,
that's
in the sense, the severity will be very low.
Yes. Yes. I just want to have a very clear cut. If it is in a corner and if it is live, the severity will be high, but the likelihood is low.
That's
okay. Yes, sir. Clear, sir. The person who is asking the doubt.
Yes,
also.
Sir. Yes, sir.
The severity, if a live cable and without insulation, the severity remains same. 5. You will give only 5, but the likelihood changes. Then the risk matrix. When you give 5, when you give the 5 severity or 4 to 5, then it is your responsibility to make sure that to bring down to the acceptable limit by giving proper control measures. Okay, we have only 3 minutes of time. Oh my God, what happened? Fine. So hazards. So hazards means sliding of cargo, coming in contact with the passers means people who are moving with bags can come in contact with the people who are walking. Because that's the reason that areas are barricaded. Slippery surfaces can be hazard. Sharp edges. What do you mean by sharp edges? Why? Because we are handling gypsum boards. Some gypsum boards which are used for pastoral parish and all.
Sir, excuse me, sir.
Fine, please.
Sir, coming into contact with bypasses means hitting the bypasses, sir?
Yeah, yes. If what actually happens, sir, they go inside, bring the bag to the outside of the premises, outside the access of pedestrian way. In that way, what we have is the pedestrian way, we have the access, and the people go inside, bring the bag and put onto the vehicle. So it is also on a pedestrian way. So what happens when the people are, if a person is walking by that way, the person who is coming from inside can come in contact with him. Yes, that is what it meant to hear the hazard. It's a real-time hazard. Sometimes we have a control measure of keeping barrications or advising people to monitor. I mean, to go when such kind of activity is going on. Otherwise, some boards has to be kept. Fine.
Okay, sir.
Fine. So improper working postures.
Excuse me, sir.
Fine. Please tell me.
Yes, sir. It is 2 minutes only. You can stop the class and ask any doubts.
Yes, sir, please, sir. Maybe so, that's what, sir. That's what. Sir. Current control measures.
Middle time.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Middle time, if they are asking that, is we are new to the class.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
We are new to hearing the safety. So we are confusing everywhere. So what I am advising,
sir, I don't know your name. You understood our main motto here, sir. You understood, right? We spoke about risk.
Yeah, yeah.
You understood our concept here, right? So okay, fine, sir. I just coming to the control measures. These are the different control measures we are giving to overcome these hazards, and we have a likelihood and severity also. Risk, we have the rating. It's a medium. Okay. So it is only 1 minute. You can ask questions if you have any doubts. So this is the standard format you have to follow. Okay. You can, depending upon your thing, you can also update it. Okay. I hope everyone has got an idea of what is risk, how we'll do it, what is risk analysis. I hope everyone understood. Okay. This is the real time risk analysis.
Yes, sir. Yes.
File. Okay. Any more doubts? Tomorrow again, I'll meet you on the next week. Okay. Good luck, everyone. Like, you work on it.
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much.
Okay. Fine.
Thank you. Thank you.
Okay. More, and we have this weight of the bag should not be more than prescribed weight of the workers. Okay. That's as per our standards. Fine. Okay. Thank you very much.
Sir.